You're looking live at the Crown Plaza in Denver, Colorado. An expected sold-out show for a night of Sparta Combat League Boxing brought to you by Brandon Dodge on Broadway. Brandon Dodge, home of the big deal, get it done. How about that? Hello, everyone. I'm your host, Todd Romero, and we are set for a night of boxing at the Crown Plaza. 10 fights on the card tonight, 4 of those professional, and highlighting the main event, Misael Lopez of Denver and Ricky Rodriguez of Greeley, Colorado, both come in undefeated. It should be an outstanding night. For more on that fight, let's bring in our resident expert, Daniel Ruacha. And Daniel, great to be here tonight.
Thank you, Tom.
10-fight card. Jeff Cisneros, the CEO of Sparta Combat League, has put together a great card. Let's talk about really the headliner of this event. This is an up-and-coming boxer. Talk about what Misael Lopez has and what kind of skills he has for this Denver boxing community.
Absolutely. Misael is a highly decorated amateur fighter who has an 8-0 boxing record as a professional, highly decorated with 50 amateur fights, and he really is what I like to call an action puncher, where he doesn't miss.
Right.
You know, this guy gets in there, he throws combinations, and he does a great job of connecting with his punches. So he's going to face a tough test today against Ricky Rodriguez, but Misael has really passed every test up to this point that he's had, and tonight's going to be another one for him.
Now, talk about Ricky Rodriguez. Comes from Greeley, Colorado. Again, a fighter, undefeated. Not as active as lately as Misael has been.
Correct. Ricky is 5-0. He's 5-0, and he was also a highly decorated amateur who fought somebody you may have heard of, Jose Ramirez.
Okay.
Who actually fought Manny Perez not too long ago, another Colorado boxer.
Yes.
Here, and an excellent professional at this point. So Ricky Rodriguez has been in there against some tough opponents, and he's against another one tonight in Misael Lopez.
You've been around the local boxing scene. What kind of chances does Misael Lopez have?
Misael is definitely the A-side tonight. He's definitely the A-side. He's a favorite fighter. But again, it's going to be a tough test tonight against Ricky Rodriguez, and Misael has to bring everything he's learned up to this point in his career to get this victory tonight.
You know, Sparta Combat League, MMA fighting and boxing, Jeff Cisneros does a great job of catering to both sports. It's amazing how this sport has exploded. I go back to the days of Felipe Garcia. I mean, heck, Ron Lyle was a fighter from Denver now. But boxing always seems to stay in the background. People think, MMA has taken over everything. But there's still a lot of the fans of the sweet science out there, and it seems like it's making a bit of a comeback.
Well, you said it. I'm a boxing fan by all accounts, you know, attended there. And boxing has always stuck around.
Right.
And I always make the argument against MMA is that MMA is definitely a sport that has a lot of different components in it. You could be a Muay Thai fighter, you could be a jiu-jitsu guy, and you can have all these different sort of disciplines that you can factor into the MMA game, but boxing is boxing. It's hand-to-hand combat, and you can't play boxing. Boxing is a true sport. And for me, I think boxing is strong, and the Colorado scene is really making some efforts here to move it forward. And I think tonight's another example of that.
If this main event goes well, I mean, I rarely do you see the promotions of this level that Jeff's done at Sparta Combat League, and be able to do that and then put on a great fight where these two fighters can put their names out there. And depending on the performance, that can only elevate the Denver fighting scene.
I agree. A fight like tonight really shows. I'm a fan of the saying, iron sharpens iron, right? And
yep,
we have
absolutely.
That going on tonight where these two gentlemen are going to step in this ring, and one of them is going to help elevate themselves to that next level. And we're going to see who the top guys in Colorado are, and then they'll be able to launch into the national and the world scene after this.
Well, you know, and some of the guys on this card fight both MMA and boxing, and that has got to take some kind of discipline.
It's two different sports, right?
I mean, yeah,
with
completely.
Boxing, with boxing, they're not going to be prepared for the takedowns or the kicks.
Right.
So does that lend to making boxing easier, MMA easier? I'm not sure which one it is. We do have a couple crossover guys fighting tonight.
Right.
Very great boxers by all accounts. So we'll see how they do tonight in the ring against some true boxers.
When you get back, I mean, the Denver fight fans, I mean, this thing's going to be packed tonight. So it's evident out there that the fight scene and the boxing scene in Denver is still alive and well. And when you see a boxer of this talent, how far can he go in your expectations? He's only 20 years old. And you and I talked about it a little bit off camera. 50 amateur fights, and I asked you if that was a lot. You're like, not too bad.
Yeah, I mean, you have some guys who fight more than that. You know, you have guys that go pro before that.
Julio
Cesar Chavez Jr. is a great example of that, who had a no amateur career by all accounts. If you can translate, the amateur and the professional boxing games are two different games by all accounts. You play these differently. The way you try to take points and the way you try to get a victory in amateur and pros is different. So Misael has to really put all of that together and continue to push. And he's done a great job up to this point of translating to the professional game. he's going to have to keep doing that tonight. And really, I would like to see him win this decisively to keep going forward in his career.
Well, you know as well as I do, Daniel, you take a look at it, you have to have all pieces of the puzzle. You have to have great training, you have to have great promotion, and then you have to have a great performance.
Absolutely, absolutely. And tonight, the production is absolutely here. The fans are filtered in already. There's a lot of excitement when it comes to this card tonight. And I think for the fighters themselves, if they could feed off of the excitement and the energy of this crowd, it's going to make for a special show tonight.
Daniel, appreciate it very much. Thanks for the insight for the main event tonight, which will be Misael Lopez and Rodriguez coming up tonight in the main event. When we come back, we got more Sparta Combat League boxing. We'll talk to Misael Lopez when we come back right here. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the Crown Plaza Hotel. Expected sellout tonight. Sparta Combat League Boxing brought to you by Brandon Dodge on Broadway. Brandon Dodge, home of the big deal. And talk about a big deal. Todd Romero back here at the Crown Plaza. 10 fights on the card tonight. Sparta Combat League. The CEO, Jeff Cisneros, has done a great job highlighting the pro side of things. It's going to be a great fight. Misael Lopez and Ricky Rodriguez is the highlight feature, 130-pound for the SCL title. Let's bring in Misael right now. And, hey, thanks for taking a few moments to speak with us.
Yes, sir. Thanks for having me, man.
Hey, talk about not only the promotion, but Sparta Combat League does a pretty good job. When you're a fighter in Colorado, a lot of times you've got to travel to get this kind of exposure, to get this kind of venue to fight in.
Definitely, man. You don't really see this in town. You know, there's some great promoters here, but nobody really takes the time to make a big show like this. You know, as a fighter, it's what you want. I said you get the best experience this way. You get the best exposure. You know, it's what you want as a fighter, man.
I mean, how being from Denver, you know, how important is that? The fact that, hey, being able to find in front of the hometown fans, and the fans get to come to an event where they can make it a night out and make it a fun night.
Yeah, man, it's huge. I mean, if you're able to keep winning these fights and keep putting on a show like this, what you want as a fighter. You start getting a fan base, you know, and this is just awesome for you, man. You need this as a fighter, you know?
All right, now let's talk about your opportunity tonight. You're headlining this tonight. It's a 10-fight card. Talk about your preparations coming into this and your training, preparing for another undefeated fighter.
Yes, sir, man. This will be our third undefeated opponent, so, you know, we've took it in, and it's a very good one, so we took this one very serious. We had about a 3-month camp or something like that. You know, we've been training really hard, hitting the mountains every weekend, you know, getting that wind going and doing as much studying as we can. And, you know, we're really ready, man. We're really excited, and we trained really hard. We're ready to put in work, man, put on a good show.
For the fans that are watching live on Facebook on the Sparta Combat League page, talk about the kind of fighter you are, what to expect from you.
I like to use my counterattacks. I like to attack when I see an opponent hurt, you know, so I'll be going to the liver a lot. I'll be trying to wear my opponent down and try to take him out in the later rounds, man.
Like the combinations, I understand you're a combination style fighter, one of those guys, you're going to be an aggressor, you like to bring the fight to your opponent.
Yes sir. I'll try to make it as exciting as I can for the fans, and I just like it myself, you know. I found the best openings, you know, making the guy open, so you'll see a very good fight. I'll be very aggressive tonight.
How much film study do you do? Obviously you talked about stepping it up and getting better fights along the way. It's so important to have a great trainer. You have a trainer that's trained some of the best.
Yes sir. My trainer is actually Aurelio Martinez and Ebenezer Lopez. You know, Martinez has had Donald Camarena. He was a WBC champion, a couple time champion, you know, so they know exactly what they're doing, and they get me prepared for all these fights, man. So, you know, we try to study as much as we can. Some opponents don't have too much film, but
right. We
try to go to the fights, or we just try to make sure we train to be ready to any kind of style that they bring us, you know. So we're ready for whatever he brings tonight, man.
So you're fighting at the 130-pound, and so this will be your venture in here. Your road, we kind of talked about it a little bit. You're somewhat a Denver native.
Yes, sir. I was born in Sonora, Mexico, very proudly, but I was raised here since I was 2 years old. You know, I'm pretty much a Colorado native. I love it here. My friends ask me, hey, you going to buy a house out of town when you become famous? You're leaving? I'm not going nowhere, man. I'm staying here. I love it here. We got the best, you know, altitude, the best stuff that you need as a boxer here, man. I'm staying here.
Well, the other thing, too, that caught me a little bit is your athletic ability and the fact that you turned down D1, D2 soccer scholarships, went to high school here in Denver to stay with the fight game.
Yes, sir. I had a couple of D2 and D1 scholarships, full rides to play soccer at the high level. I couldn't leave this, man. You know, I said, okay, what do I like better, winning a fight or winning a soccer game? Not even close, man. I love this stuff way too much, so I had to stick with it.
Well, was it tough, though? Was it a tough decision?
Oh, man, it was tough for myself mainly, but it was also tough for my teachers. You know, as a teacher, they tell you, oh, you know, there's a scholarship, free college,
right.
you got to go. But I went against everybody, man. I said, you know what, I'm going to box. I love it. I know I have what it takes. I'm sticking with it.
Last one for you tonight. I mean, give me the perfect game plan tonight of if it goes the way you want to go. I mean, I know you can't predict things,
yes,
but kind of the style of fight and the way things you want it to go.
Okay, so we know he's a really good counterattacker. You know, he's got some experience, so we're going to be patient at the beginning, try to see the opening, see what he's going to bring, and then after maybe a couple, 2-3 rounds, we're going to start stepping it up, hitting the body work, wearing him down, and then try to take him out in the later rounds. That's my man. I'm trying to take him out, man.
Talk about coming up to this. When you train, do you train against guys that are a little bit heavier than you, guys that are quick? Is it something that your trainer makes sure that you have a little flavor of everything?
Yes, sir. He does very well at that. We actually try to do about 3 or 4 different guys during our sparring matches,
right.
Do a couple rounds, bring him in fresh, and we'll do a tall guy, we'll do a fast guy, you know. We'll look at different looks for the same reason. So you don't know what he's going to bring. Sometimes they change up and stuff, so got to be ready for whatever they bring, man.
And how did you hook up with Aurelio? Because, I mean, you don't just get lucky.
No,
you got to
have
some skills to draw his attention. Isn't it a 50-50 partnership?
Yeah, pretty much, man. So what happened is when I was younger, I've been boxing and playing soccer balanced all my life. So
right.
When I was about 15 years old, I started playing semi-pro soccer. It's an academy. We play against all the MLS teams.
Right.
And I kind of stepped away from the boxing scene. I said, you know, I'm going to take a break. And once I finished that, I missed it too much. So I called him back, and I was like, hey, you know, I'm thinking of coming back. And he said, well, let me take care of you. I said, well, there's nobody better than you, you know. So we got hooked up again. He motivated me again. He said, you know, stay with it, man. You got what it takes. He said, I've had world champions, and you got what it takes. So he motivated me, got me back in it, and we've been together ever since, man.
Your gym and your training center, how much did they help you prepare? Give a shout-out to those guys if you want.
Oh, man, it's awesome. I want to give a shout-out to Ricky Lopez, man, Alejandro Castillo, you know, great pros from Colorado who helped me get ready. Mike Alvarado's great advice, man. He's always there showing us love, you know, giving us tips and and helping us stay on track, you know, from his experience, my father, you know, my coach, my family. I had family flying from Mexico, from Arizona.
Wow.
You know, I have a lot of people have my back, man, so I appreciate that a lot. Everybody at home, thank you guys so much. You know, Colorado, you guys are really behind me.
Now, do you have to, have you had to travel outside of state for any of your fights yet? Is that?
Not as a professional, but as an amateur, yeah, man, I got to the point where I couldn't really get fights locally. You know, I had to beat a lot of guys locally, so I was going everywhere. I went to California to fight Hernando Gomez. He was the number one in the U.S. at the time. He signed with Golden Boy. Shout out to him. He's a really good fighter. So I had to go out and fight him in San Diego in his home. I had to fight in Arizona. I had to fight in New Mexico. I had to fight in Texas, Louisiana. You know, we went all over because it got to the point where I wasn't busy enough locally.
Right.
So, you know, you had to do what you had to do.
Well, guess what? You're here tonight.
Yes, sir.
Main event. Good luck tonight against Ricky Rodriguez. Glad to see you here fighting in the 303.
Thank you very much, man. I'm excited.
All right. Misael Lopez fighting in the main event tonight, the 130-pound SCL title against Ricky Rodriguez. That is the main event of the 10-fight card. When I come back, we'll have an interview with Jeff Cisneros, the CEO of Sparta Combat League. Welcome back to a sold-out Crown Plaza Hotel, Denver, Colorado, a night of Sparta Combat League Boxing, brought to you by Brandon Dodge on Broadway. Brandon Dodge, home of the big deal. Welcome back, everyone. Todd Romero here at the Crown Plaza Hotel, getting you set for a 10-fight card highlighted by the main event. Misael Lopez and Ricky Rodriguez of Greeley, both undefeated. We just had Misael on. It's time to bring in the CEO of the Sparta Combat League, Jeff Cisneros. And hey, this is an exciting night.
Todd, I'm so pumped up for tonight. We have a sold-out crowd. The electricity's in the air. And what's most impressive, we're showcasing the young stars of Sparta Combat League Boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, you're in for a real treat tonight.
I'll tell you, talking to the fighters, Jeff, and I mean, you do both MMA and the fight fans out there for Sparta Combat League. No, you do MMA, you do boxing. And talking to the fighters, the first thing they said is there's not an event, there's not a promotion like this that's out there in the 303. In other words, you're the top billing event as far as how you put things together. And when you have the boxers talk like that, it's got to make you feel good.
It feels good. But, you know, first of all, Todd, we wouldn't be able to do this without our incredible team. We have an amazing team, an amazing support structure, and we work really hard to bring a production level like this today. And so when you put all those tools together, the fans are in for a real treat.
All right, 10 fights tonight. 4 of these fights are pros. I mean, and people, I don't know if you know what goes into making a fight and matching a fight, making sure you try to get, you know, obviously you can't guarantee what the outcomes of fights are, but right. You try to match guys as evenly as you can, guys that are moving up the ladder, guys that have established themselves. It's kind of a fine art, isn't it?
It really is. And, you know, myself and our matchmakers tonight, Chris Messis, he's over here ringside, we study film. We sit there and we watch videos of multiple fighters, and we see what they want, like how they line up, how they match up. And we've become pretty successful at it. I mean, you know, every now and then it goes a complete opposite way, but we study hard.
You know, I know Chris from back in the days. I met him at actually Mike Alvarado's gym probably about 4 years ago when I did a story on Mike Alvarado, who boxing fans in Denver know. But let's talk about Misael Lopez a little bit. We just had him on here. He's a fighter. He's eager to get going here, 20 years old. But turned down D1 and D2 soccer scholarships to pursue the sweet science.
You know, Misael is a special talent. And if you have not seen him fight, you're in for a real treat tonight, Todd. 20 years old, like you said, his upside, the sky's the limit. This kid is unbelievable. He has it all. He has speed. He has power. He has charisma. The kid is a bona fide star. But don't get it wrong. Tonight, he's fighting another young prospect in Ricky Rodriguez, who's undefeated for a reason. And they come from a strong camp. We're going to be in for a barn burner in this one.
Yeah, both fighters in the top 100. And be able to get that. Obviously, you got the fight fans out here tonight on Facebook tonight where you can watch the fights. That's a key for people on Facebook to know that these fights are going to be on tonight, to stay tuned. Give me some other action on this card that you think might draw a little of the fans' attention.
So I'm really excited, and one of the third from the start pro fights, Jose Arellano from Chihuahua, Mexico. He is unbelievable. When you see this kid, he's going to knock your socks off. But he's fighting a very tough, crafty veteran who's been in there with some of the best in Isaac Johnson. But the kid is unbelievable. So that fight's going to be good. We're going to start it off with Cruz Valenzuela versus Chris Arguello. Fireworks. That's all I can say, Todd. They both move forward. They're both aggressive. When that happens, we have combustion.
A lot goes together to put together a fight. And there's bumps in the road a lot of the times. But how are you guys able to put this kind of product on? Is it just, it takes a lot of work. It just doesn't happen overnight.
You know, it's a lot of work, Todd. And we have an incredible team. We work very hard. We work long hours to bring this product. But the fighters themselves, they market themselves very well. And they're a huge draw in here as well. And so without them, we couldn't do it. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Well, when you take a look at this now, and you take a look at the fighters that have come up in Denver, and it's an interesting mix because UFC 1 was in Denver. Now you started your own brand. MMA is huge in Colorado. You have all the gyms up and down the Front Range. I go back in the days of Felipe Garcia, Jimmy Tapia, obviously Mike Alvarado fighting out of Denver. It seems like there's still now some up-and-coming fighters. Boxing's resurfacing in the 303.
You know, it's crazy. Tonight's card, the oldest boxer on the card is just 26 years old.
Wow.
And the highlight of the 4 pro fights, the guys range from 19 years old to 26 years old. And so we're going to truly see the next generation of boxing stars here tonight. Just like in mixed martial arts, we were talking, Todd, right. January 7th. We're seeing the evolution of the sport. Age 18, they're incredible. They've been training mixed martial arts since they were 3 years old. What's different about the boxing product is they truly get to craft one single thing in boxing, and you're going to see it on a very high level. Tonight is going to be our breakthrough moment for SEL boxing.
But there are some fighters on this card that are MMA fighters that cross over. Mind-wise, I'm going, how do they do that? Because you get in a situation, you go, okay, we can only punch.
Right. One of the funny things, Todd, is Alejandro Ibarra. He's looking to become a 3-division boxing champion. He was also an MMA champion at 155. The kid is incredibly talented. He packs a huge punch, and he's good at both. You know, he's a hybrid, and we're seeing some of that. Guys that can do boxing, kickboxing, and MMA.
Talk about the fellas that'll call the action tonight a little bit.
You know, we got J.R. Gordon and Ron Goldstein. J.R. Gordon is an almanac in combat sports history, MMA, boxing, the whole nine. And Ron, he just has so much excitement and passion for the sport. you guys are in for a real treat with them. They're a terrific tandem.
Should be great stuff, absolutely. Jeff, appreciate your time. Should be a great card tonight, 10 fights on the card. So continue to watch on Facebook. For those of you that can get out of here, still have opportunity to get out of here, right? Or are we sold out?
Looks like we're sold out at this moment, so we're going to close down doors. Full House, you missed out, but go ahead and tune in, watch on Facebook Live. We've put a lot of effort into this. This is a test television run for us, Todd, to show how we can produce live on TV.
Obviously, a couple quick events that are coming up for fight fans out there. So in case you got their attention right now, what's good? What do you got coming up on MMA?
We got March 11th. We're going to make our debut in Rapid City, South Dakota. Excited about that. March 18th, we come back here to Grizzly Rose in Denver, Colorado. And then, Todd, the one we've all been waiting for.
AVM.
AVM, Battle of the Military Forces, April 22nd, live at Budweiser Event Center, featuring Anthony Sugarfoot Adams and Justin J. Train Gonzalez. It's going to be a treat.
Yeah, Justin J. Train is climbing the tree, that is for sure. They can get tickets where?
SpartaCombatLeague.com. Again, that's SpartaCombatLeague.com.
All right, there it is. Jeff Cisneros, the CEO of Sparta Combat League. Well, JR and Ron will have all the action coming up soon. 10 fights on the card, highlighted by Misael Lopez and Ricky Rodriguez. Stay tuned for fighting.